us out of darkness, from bringing us out of darkness into your marvelous light. We thank you, Lord, for healing. We thank you, Lord, for deliverance. We thank you, Lord, for healing our emotional hurts, our emotional pains. We thank you, Lord, for healing our physical hurts and our physical pains. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for being a very present help in the time of trouble, in the time of need. And now, Lord, we commend the rest of this service into your hands. We ask you, Lord, that you grant the door of utterance in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. As you remain standing, just turn with me over to the book of Hebrews chapter 13. Hebrews chapter 13. Truly, the God that we serve is a mighty God. The angels bow before him. The heavens and the earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. And as you are finding Hebrews 13, it's actually headed towards the conclusion of this particular book that was handwritten by Timothy, dictated by Paul. And as we begin to look at Hebrews chapter 13 and verse number 20, it enters into a benediction. And this is a benediction scripture. And it says, "Now the God of peace that brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. Through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen." I want to read that again in your hearing. "Now the God of peace that brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. Through Jesus Christ, to him be glory forever. Amen." You may be seated in the sanctuary. And we certainly want to take a thought on today in reference to our scripture text that we read in your hearing. The power is in the blood. The power is in the blood. And this is a particular fitting scripture that we've read, seeing that we had partook of the body and the blood of Jesus in our communion with him. And Jesus said, as you have already been exposed to, he said, "As often as you do this in remembrance of me." The Lord always wants us to remember him. The Lord always wants us to remember not only him, but what he has literally done for us. And in remembrance of what he has done for us, the Lord has literally brought us a mighty long way. And I want to turn your attention to another verse of scripture before we actually get into our text, and it helps us to understand our text. I want you to go with me. You don't have to stand, but go with me to the book of Ephesians, Ephesians chapter number 2. Because it's important to remember that we were at one time disconnected from the Lord. We were disjointed from him. And this is the particular one of the reasons why Jesus wants us to remember him. Ephesians chapter 11, chapter number 2, verse 11, it says, "Wherefore, remember that ye being in time past Gentiles in the flesh. In other words, AKA, remember you were unsaved. Thank you, Lord. Who are called uncircumcision by that which is called the circumcision. You were called unsaved according to the law of the Lord and the Jews. And verse number 12, it says that at that time you were without Christ. At one time we were without Christ. We were without Jesus. And being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel and strangers from the covenant of promise, having no hope, my God, can't believe it, having no hope. And at one time we were without God in this world. But the scripture says, but now, somebody say, but now in Christ Jesus, ye who were sometimes for afar off are made nigh by the blood of Christ. For he is our peace. He is our peace who have made both one, Jew and Gentile, and broken down that middle wall of partition between us. The reason why we have literally read those particular scriptures, I wanted you to see that at one time you were literally disconnected to God, and you were also disconnected from the God of promise. And the scripture says that you are without hope in this world. But as we begin to look at the scriptures on today, it says that, but now in Christ Jesus, the scripture says that there is therefore now no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus. If you are a born again believer, baptized in his name, have repented for your sins, the Bible says that you are saved by grace and not through faith in Jesus. The scripture tells us that we were not redeemed by the blood of bulls and goats and heifers, but we were redeemed by the precious blood of Jesus. We were literally brought into covenant relationship with him through his blood. There's something about the blood. The Bible tells us that it is in the blood of Jesus that it connects us to the promises of God. It's in the blood of Jesus that not only washes away our sins, but he says, when I see the blood, death shall pass over you. When he sees the blood gives you life, and that allows you to have not life in a small portion, but life more abundantly. And when we think about what God has literally done for us, we were disconnected and we were without hope. We were ships without a sail. But when it came down to the sacrifice of Jesus, Jesus gave his life for you and I, he reconnected us. He restored us. He renewed us. He revived us. And he reconnected us to all the promises of God. He reconnected us to all the power that is in God through Jesus Christ. The Bible says now the God of peace. Your God is a God of peace. He looks at you and he wants to have peace with you. When it came time for your reconciliation, the Bible says that God was in Christ reconciling the world back unto himself. And I thank God for the word of God, because it allows me to know that he didn't put your salvation in the hands of angels. He didn't put your salvation in the hands of mortal men. He put your salvation in his own hands. Hallelujah. That's why he's described as the God of peace, the God of shalom, the God of more than enough. My brothers and sisters, we've got to realize who we're serving and who we are. We got to realize that we've been bought with a price and we are not our own. He's the God of Jacob. He's the God of Abraham and the God of Isaac. And you should also say, he's my God. Hallelujah. He's my God, the great I am. Hallelujah. And if God be for you, who then can be against you? If God says you're saved, you're saved right now. If God had bought you with that price, the blessed blood of Jesus, hallelujah, the sacrifice. There's no other sacrifice that God accepts except the blood. That's why we plead the blood over our life. We plead the blood over our circumstances and our situation. But for today's text, I want you to see that the blood of Jesus, it brings you into relationship with your God. The blood of Jesus, it brings you into covenant relationship with him. Once you're in covenant relationship with God, when you were without hope, now you got a hope. When you were without promises, now you got a great and precious promises. By these that you're able to declare, you're able to wage warfare on the enemy. You're able to praise him in the midst of every storm. You're able to praise him, hallelujah, when things seem to be going wrong. You can count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptation, because you're in a covenant relationship with him, because you've been bought with that price, the precious blood of Jesus. Because my God, the enemy can't do nothing to you, because God is on your side. The devil can't do nothing with you, because God has redeemed you. You've been bought with that price. Hallelujah. And whom the Son is set free, the Bible says, is free indeed. That's why when we go through our tests and our trials, you ought to lift up your bowed down head and strengthen your feeble knees. You ought to give your God a praise and count it all joy. My God, don't let the enemy steal your joy. Don't let the devil steal your purpose, because God has on your side. When you declare that God is my salvation, when you say the Lord is my life and my salvation, because you got a promise, you should say, whom shall I fear? When the enemy tries to come against me and try to turn me around, in this you shall not be afraid. My God, don't be afraid, brothers and sisters, of the terror by day. Don't be afraid that the arrow that comes by night. Don't allow the enemy to take your joy. Don't allow the devil to steal your peace. You may have some ups, you may have some downs, but if you call on the name of Jesus, the Bible says that the name of the Lord is a strong tower. And the righteous runneth in, and they are safe. When you call on that name, because you in a covenant relationship with God, the devil has to back up. When you call on that name, because you in a covenant relationship with God, you can lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Because you can call on that name, my God, the whole earth has to bow in submission to your words of declare and your walk by faith. That's why we ought to walk by faith and not by sight. It's not about what I see, it's about what's in the word. It's not about how I feel, it's about who I am. You ought to give him a praise for this peace that we have, this shalom that we have. Comes through the everlasting covenant. That covenant binds us. I want you to understand, brothers and sisters, that when you're in a relationship with God, and God keeps his promises. The Bible says that the Lord knoweth them that are his. He knows every word. Sometimes we don't honor our promises, but God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. And when we think of being in a covenant relationship with God, we need to understand that God honors the covenant. God honors the blood. God echoes. Hallelujah. God esteems the blood better than any other thing. God knows them that are his and those that call on his name. When you put your trust in Jesus, not just some things, but everything is going to be all right. Why? Because I'm in a covenant with God. I know who I believe. I know who we trust in. I know that it's going to get better after a while. When you're walking with God, you can say to yourself that it's after a while these trials are going to be over. After a while the sun is going to shine. After a while I'm going to have a better day. Why? Because I'm trusting. I'm trusting in the Lord. Somebody say, I'm trusting. I'm trusting in the Lord. I'm believing, not in my own might. I'm believing in God. Because you're in a covenant relationship with him, you can be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. It's not about my power. It's not about your power, but it's about the power of the Lord. When you're in a covenant, you can say that the battle doesn't belong to me, but the battle belongs unto the Lord. And then you can look your enemy in the eye with all confidence and say, this God that I serve on a continual basis, he's well able to do exceeding and abundant above all that I'm able to ask or think. You see, when you're in this covenant, though you were a wayward person, though you had some hurts, though you had some problems, notice what it says, that the God of peace, that he make you perfect. And this type of perfection, it doesn't mean that he makes you mature, but this perfection in this particular scripture, it means that he reconnects you, that you were disjointed, that you were out of joint, but God, by his reasonable power, that God by his reasonable might, have you ever broken a bone in your body and you had to go to the doctor and the doctor takes your bone and he resets it. He resets that bone and he puts a cast around it so that that bone can heal and be reconnected to your body. My God, somebody help me up in here. You see, when we were born in Adam disconnected us to God. But Jesus, who is that great physician, I said, Jesus, who is that lily of the valley, I said, Jesus, he reconnected us. He reconnected us, and now we are attached to the body of Christ. Now we are attached to the body made whole, and we are his workmanship, created or designed in Christ Jesus, prepared unto every good work. Come on and clap your hands and give God a praise. I broke my arm at one time, and what got me over the hump was the doctor told me. He said, well, brother, he didn't call me a brother. He said, well, son, where that break is, it's
it's going to be stronger. It's going to be better. Oh my God. And when I look at what Jesus he did for us, our relationship with God, it's stronger. It's better. When Adam did us in and Jesus saved us, he made us better. Come on and give God a praise. Come on and give God a praise. Aren't you glad that now there is therefore now no condemnation which is in Christ Jesus? Aren't you glad that you can praise him? You can give him glory and honor. That you can lift up your hands and say, Lord, I thank you. Thank you for bringing me out of darkness. I thank you for walking me into your marvelous light. I thank you that I'm better. I'm a better praiser. I'm a better worshiper. I'm a better ekalabosh. I'm a better kikabosh. I'm ekalabosh. Every trial that happens, God has made you better. Every time the enemy tries to come up against you, God has made you better. When you go through your tests, when you come out more than a conqueror, you are better. You can see clearly that your God, he is the God that is able to do exceedingly and abundantly, because I'm better. Come on and give God a praise. Son of the Most. Now unto him. Somebody say, now unto him that is able. Tell your person next to you, your God is able. Y'all may be seated. The God of peace did that. The God of peace himself, through the precious blood of Jesus, made you better. Hallelujah. No weapon formed against us, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. Why? Because I'm better. Hallelujah. Because we're connected to the covenant relationship with our God through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Somebody ought to give God a praise. Shama, because I'm better, I can do his will. Because I'm better, hallelujah, I can walk in his ways. Because I'm better, I can give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good and his mercy endureth forever. My God, I'm out of time. Hallelujah. But I'm not out of the word. I want to preach on, but let the church stand. Hey, hallelujah. Hallelujah. There is power. Power. In the blood. Blood of the Lamb. There is power. Wonder working power. One more time. There is power. Wonder working power. It's in the blood. The blood of the Lamb. Hey! Wonder working power. Hallelujah. Gracious Father. Lord, we thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that we now, when we did not have a hope, now we have a hope. When we were disconnected from all the promises, now we are connected to all the promises. Lord, we thank you for washing away our sins. We thank you for dying on the cross. We thank you that we have a mediator that can be touched with the feelings of our infirmities. We thank you, hallelujah, that we can come boldly to the throne of grace, that we might obtain mercy and find grace to help us,
Oh, we thank you that goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. For when we make a mistake, when we fall by the wayside, when we commit a sin, we can call on the precious blood of Jesus. Ah, that will sanctify us. That will wash our sins away. We thank you. Hallelujah. Now, Lord, we ask you that you search the hearts of these great people. If there's be any that need to be baptized, hallelujah, let them come to be baptized in your name. Hallelujah. If there's any, Lord, that need the precious gift of the Holy Ghost, we pray right now, Lord, that you fill them. We fill them with the Holy Ghost and with power. We pray right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, that you sanctify our hearts, that you sanctify our minds, that we might do your will, that we might accomplish your purpose. Father, we thank you. We give you glory and honor. We give you praise in the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling, to present you faultless before his presence with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, to him be glory both now and forever. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah.